Hello everyone, it's a new month, and a new beginning for the squad, so, let's start September with a bang, beginning with an awesome synergy between Mag and the newest sentient shotgun, PHANTASMA. Now I know there are a couple of weapon that synergies really well with Mag. There's the Astilla which I featured way back when I was a pleb in Warframe, also, there's that crazy synergy between Mag and the famous Eidolon hunting sniper Lanka. As crazy and as odd as it seems, Lanka is really powerful when used by Mag, as it melts the enemies really fast when you shoot those beams on those magnetized enemies. There's also those infested testicles that spreads AIDS like crazy to the enemies while using Mag. Also, there's Statica which can also melt the enemies in seconds. And yes, there's the famous Maraditron, which synergies really well with Mag. By the way, I will be making a detailed Maraditron build next, so be sure to watch out for it. So anyway, what separates the PHANTASMA from the rest of these awesome weapons for Mag you asked? Among the weapons I have mentioned earlier, PHANTASMA, when used with magnetize, has one of the highest damage output for Mag. Since its secondary fire is a cannon mode, the damage distribution to those enemies caught in magnetize bubble will somehow be evenly distributed, which leads to faster kills. In fact, I can rank PHANTASMA as second in terms of dealing the most damage when it comes to weapons that are good for magnetize. In addition, PHANTASMA has a really high status chance which makes it endgame viable, especially when you are using it with Mag. Just take a look at this. We can strip the armors of these units really fast that we can actually wait for our magnetized bubble to explode and kill them. But that's not all. Remember that PHANTASMA has those small bomblets that tracks down enemies right after the explosion, when you use the cannon mode on those magnetized targets. It seems that those projectiles will track those targets inside the bubble, giving more damage output. It's truly a new way to enjoy Mag, and it's really fun nuking those enemies. Okay, now that you have a clear understanding on how awesome PHANTASMA is with Mag, let's proceed to the modding section of this video. Let's begin with Mag. But before we proceed to my builds, I would just like to say that the builds you'll see are personal preference and you can just use these as reference to make your very own build. But anyway, I will explain why I choose these mods for both Mag and PHANTASMA. Okay, let's begin. So for Mag, I have this mod set up. As you can see, it's a pretty balanced build, with power strength being the priority. Why? So that magnetize will have as much damage multiplier and explosion damage as much as possible. Now, you can actually trim a bit of power strength on this build, by removing auger secrets, and replacing it with any mods that you find useful. I would suggest the counter pulse augment for solo plays as it allows you to crowd control enemies using your polarize ability. I also have streamline for efficiency in this build and of course, primed flow so I have enough energy to cast my abilities. I'm usually a push all button while using mag so energy is really a must for me. I just love using all the abilities of Mag as even though her abilities are not that synergetic like Nidas, it has their own uses which makes them functional. I also have stretch for some range on my crush ability. Your fourth ability is really great not only for crowd control, but also for giving you survivability. Remember that this ability does give Mag over shield and, you can actually have 2310 max over shield when you have redirection on the mix. Now that excludes the overshield that Axe and Sentinel can give you, I know shields are pretty underrated, and not commonly used by most people as they prefer vitality. Well, you can put vitality on this slot if you are going for a casual walk with Mag on low to medium level missions. However, I find shield really good in missions like long survival runs, especially if you have the ancient healer Spectre that can reduce the damage dealt by enemies. Do remember that the healer's buff to decrease damage taken can also affect shields, so that is why I choose redirection for survival runs. Okay, now let's proceed with my PHANTASMA build. Now for those who have watched my PHANTASMA video, then you probably know by now how I modded this new sentient shotgun. I did not change anything on my mod setup, it's still the same. Now this is my usual mod setup for infested units. I really don't bother going with blast or any other elements, as most of the infested units are affected also by corrosive. In addition, we will be utilizing Mag's magnetize ability so our PHANTASMA will deal more damage. I did have another dual status mods in the form of Scattering Inferno, which is good against infested somehow, but, I changed this mod with Frigid Blast when facing heavily armored units. When facing corpus units, I just go with a gas build, and then add Shell Shock in the mix. Now, The third dual status mod is not just that to give bonus damage to factions, but also to give us that sweet 100% status chance. Also, I have Vicious Spread in this slot, as it adds more spread and damage to the secondary fire mode of Phantasma, which by the way, the fire mode we will be using most of the time. Lastly, I have Repeated Clip. Now this mod is really great with Phantasma, as this sentient shotgun have a really fast reload speed. 0.5 seconds to be exact, so probably, we can proc that fire 8 buff almost every time, which we need so we can charge the secondary fire much faster. It's not really needed to charge the secondary fire though, I charge it most of the time for more damage output. So that's it, Phantasma is a new way to enjoy while playing mag. It's a fairly powerful synergy too, that you can even take it on endgame levels. I just hope that you enjoy watching this video and find it informative. Before you leave, please do me a favor and hit that like button. If you want to watch more Warframe videos from us, then don't forget to subscribe. Just remember to turn on notifications to receive daily updates on our channel. Lastly, if you happen to have a Discord account, then come join the squad in our very own server. Link to Discord server is on the video description below. Thank you so much for watching. Squad Leader signing off.